Hi, I'm Prince Agarwal. This is LabVIEW Learnings with Exilic, and today we are going to learn how to quickly create custom timer. In order to create a timer, let us place one while loop on the block diagram and wire true constant to the conditional terminal. Now let us place this get date time in seconds and convert this value into DBL. In order to convert to DBL, go to conversion and place this to double precision float, right? So over here we are getting the date and time in seconds. Now let us quickly calculate the DT value, that is the difference between every iteration. And what we are going to do from now on is we are going to calculate the DT for every iteration, and we are going to add the same DT with every iteration from the with the last iteration value. And how we are going to do that is by placing the add element. Let us create one shift register over here, and let us store the current time value in the shift register. Again, quickly create this to shift register. So now we are getting the current value and we are getting the last iteration time value in seconds. And by subtracting these two values, we are calculating the DT part, right? So let me write it over here that we are calculating DT, right? And now over here, we are adding the DT that we just deduced with every iteration. And this is how we are going to add. So now over here, we are adding the DT values, right? Now, if I run this timer, you can see that the timer will start to run. But like, since we are using the uninitialized shift register, so we have to reset the time value in order so that we don't get the garbage value. Now let us try to enter the functionality of reset. And how we are going to do that is use the select function in the comparison palette. And what we are trying to achieve over here is whenever the reset button is pressed, the timer value should be reset to zero, right? So if this is true, I will wire the constant zero. And if this is false, then I'll pass the last value to the shift register, right? Let me quickly delete this value and wire it through. And like this. So this is how we are adding DT, and this is how we are resetting the value to zero. Let me write it down. Right. So now this is my time required and this is my elapsed time. So to get the value in the elapsed time, wire the terminal into the elapsed time indicator. Now this is my time required. I can set whatever time I would like to my timer to run. But quickly I'll show you how this is going to work. So if I run this VI continuously, because I've wired the while loop to run only once, so I have to run it continuously. As you can see, the uninitialized shift register changes the value from 0 to the maximum value. Now let us reset the timer. Now the value has been reset to 0. And now if I untick the reset, that is false, as you can see, my timer is started to run. Let me stop this VI and convert the timer into the time required functionality. Let us place greater or equal value. So whenever the current time that has been elapsed is greater from the mentioned time in time required, then it should turn true, right? Now let us run the VI once again. Now as you can see, I have to time required will be, like, for example, 5 seconds. And if I run it, as you can see, it is showing the maximum value. Let us reset the time. Time has been elapsed. And if I do this like this, right? I think this has, okay, right. As you can see, this time is already greater than, okay, I think we have to change the wires. Now it is going to work just fine. Now if I run the VIV again continuously, you can see reset like this, time elapse is false, and after 5 seconds time elapse will turn to true. So this is how we create a custom timer. Thank you.